Heard strange slurps on FaceTime with my girlfriend and snuck into her house to investigate. She broke down crying on the ground and yelled when I saw what's going on. Bro. I am on FaceTime with my girl at the moment, and she is home alone, or at least supposed to be. A little into the FaceTime call, I fall asleep, but wake up to go to the restroom, and I hear weird moaning noises coming from the phone, followed by swishing noises like someone is using mouthwash. I listen closely for like 5 minutes to make sure I'm not tripping, then finally ask her, "What are you doing?" In a nice tone, hopefully trying to not sound sus. She replies saying, "Laying down." That's when I ask her what all those noises are, and she says, "I'm not doing anything." I'm silent ash after that, and she says she's still sick. This girl knows she hasn't mentioned that sure to me at all for the past few days. But I'm like, duck it and tell her, okay, I'm going on mute cause I might snore, which is cap. I'm finna listening to hard ash. So I listen and I keep hearing the same noise. I only see crap like this on Twitter, bro. No way am I getting cheated on while on the phone. No way. How do I go about this? Edit, she lives about 17 minutes away via Duck Toll Road. I'm about to pull up and keep y'all posted. Edit, so I pulled up on her, while on the phone muted the whole time, and the first thing I looked for were any cars that I normally don't see. To my surprise, I don't see any. At this point I'm questioning myself, like, am I tripping? Maybe she for real sick. And think about getting in the car to turn home, but I get that gut feeling. Y'all know that feeling I'm talking about. That nah, look into this crap some more but feeling. So I knock on the door and she doesn't answer, but I hear her on the phone move around on the cover. I knock again and this time her phone goes on mute and she puts me on pause. At this point I'm like, lol, some is definitely up. She finally answers the door and the look on her face is priceless. I'm like, a what's up? I just wanted to come see you. And she's like, oh hey, what are you doing here? I like chillin' and crap. At that point, it's pretty awkward and I can tell she's super uncomfortable and doesn't want me to come in. I try to kinda barge my way in and she blocks my path. We make eye contact for like 30 full seconds and to break the silence she says I'm not allowed to have anyone inside, even though she's snuck me over to her house several times and her mom even allowed it while she's gone. So I say, I know I'm not trippin', some is off and I want you to let me inside. She puts her hand on my chest as I walk in and she's like, no, you're acting crazy. There's nothing wrong. And I hate being gaslight, so I'm like, aight. And start to walk away. As I walk away, the FaceTime call hangs up and I look at the door and she's still there. At first I don't think much of it, but then I look at her hands, and she doesn't have her phone. That means someone else hung her phone up. At that point I start tweaking for real. I push her butt out the way and make my way to her room. As I'm walking I can hear her screaming my name, but I'm not giving a duck. I finally make my way to her room, and as soon as I open the door my stomach drops, dude. I literally can't believe my eyes, like this some crap you see straight out of a movie for real. In her bed is a dude shirtless with the blanket pulled over his legs and crap, looking me straight in the eye as I'm looking him straight in the eye. That's when I hear her footsteps behind me. She grabs me from behind and is like, baby, I'm so sorry, I'm sorry, and crying and crap. Now I'm not a woman slapper, but I've never wanted to slap a girl so bad in my life. I'm still making eye contact with this dude and he glaring off to the side, nervous as hell. After about 30 seconds of this, something in my mind just snaps and all of the sudden I don't feel shocked anymore. I look at her. She was crying and crap on the ground and crap. I look at him. He was sweating his butt off looking at me. And I grab all the crap I ever bought her that I could see in the room and go with the most straight face I've ever made in my life. She chased me on my way out the house talking about how she loves me and crap, but I'm not feeling nothing. I keep my straight face and walk to my car and take off, dude. The whole ride home. Blowing my phone up. The whole walk inside. Blowing my phone up. She'd still be callin' now if I didn't block her. I have no idea how I'm going to handle this, but this crap ducked up how it happened, fam. It's ducking her, but this crap for sure hurts. Edit, I have decided to never talk to her again. I got the closure I needed and won't give her the luxury of getting hers. Furthermore, the guy came to me and was like he had no idea she had a boyfriend and that he thought she was making snaps when she was talking to me. Somehow the whole school knows about what she did, and a lot of people have shunned her for it. I'm not saying it's a good thing, but karma is a girl. We have reached the end of the story. Let's listen to some of the comments by our Reddit listeners. Comment 1. What do you do? Call her mother and tell her that you are breaking up with her daughter because she was acting weird on the phone last night, so you went over and found a naked guy in her bed that she was giving him mouth and ready to sleep with him. Tell her you felt she deserves to know why you guys broke up because she was caught cheating. Comment 2. Wow, man. Your intuition, 10 out of 10. Your observational skills, 10 out of 10. Your reaction, 10 out of 10. Not many guys deal with cheaters as smart as you did. Some guys ask the girl if she's cheating in too much of a direct manner. Some guys snap and start asking questions that the cheater cannot answer. Some guys stay with the girl, which is ridiculous. Some guys try to fight the other guy. Some guys try to stay friends after a breakup. But you, my friend, you decided not to simp. Got back home early where my sick girlfriend was missing, but instead I found a strange wrapper sticking from under her dresser. Me and my GF went on vacation recently, but due to flights being expensive, we bought the cheapest ones we could possibly find, meaning we had to get different flights at different times from different airports. Long story short, she ended up coming home a week earlier than me. Things started to seem pretty off at this point. She told me she thinks they got the flu and was the sickest she had ever been in her life, which at the time I totally believed. She would sleep all day cause she was sick, and some days she wouldn't call or text me once, which is very out of the usual for her, but once again, if you're really sick, it makes sense. Here's where the problem arises. This time I get home while my GF is out for a few days for work, and I notice first and foremost, the apartment is immaculately clean, which is great, but leads to a problem shortly. Secondly, I notice our futon couch is not only in futon form, but spun all the way around. This may seem like a weird thing to be sus about, but I almost know for a fact my GF can't move the couch due to it being wicked heavy. It's almost a two-person job for me, and plus she was cripplingly sick. Thirdly, I notice all the pictures and decorations with my face or name on them are taken down, really weirded out now. And then the cherry on top, inside of our now very clean bedroom, I noticed something that would have been hard to miss when cleaning, if it was there before, an open rubber wrapper sticking about halfway out from under our dresser, which has an arch under it. I have two huge boxes of rubbers here that we use, and it's the same kind, so some may say it was just from us, but the problem is, not only would that have been hard to miss while cleaning, but we haven't had sex in a pretty significant amount of time. And before you comment saying just ask her, I did, and she got pretty defensive, and just texted bruh no, I didn't have anyone over, stop asking. She only calls me bro when she's pissed, by the way, haha. So, what do you think? We have reached the end of the story. Let's listen to some of the comments by our Reddit listeners. Comment 1. Dude, I think you know the answer already. Don't know whose place it is, but either kick her to the curb or move out. OP reply. Unfortunately, even though she works at my business I own, so money from me pays rent, I let her sign the lease. RIP. Even better, she recently talked about having me sign a contract that if anything happens to us, and we sell the business, we'd split at good times. Comment 2. What was her explanation for hiding everything with your face on it? OP reply. Okay, so first time I asked she said WDYM, I just moved one thing, which was in reference to a license plate I have on the wall with my name on it. It's been there forever and looks good where it's at, which she herself has said, but I just figured maybe she moved it when she was cleaning cause she changed her mind. That's when I looked around and saw everything with me was taken down and hidden, so I asked her again and she said it was because she was mad at me cause we got into a little argument before we left. I didn't buy it cause usually she's not that, we argued a little, so I took down all the pictures of you type. My fiance ghosted me right before our wedding with no reason, and later truth came out and made me shocked and devastated. A lot has been going on in my life and I feel like I can't handle it. I have recently lost a good job, and I can't find a new one despite all the effort I put in every day. I couldn't afford my flat anymore, so I had to move in with my parents, who already think I am a failure as compared to my older siblings. The reason I did not move in with my fiancé is our culture. We can't really live together before getting married. My wedding is in late February, and I honestly do not look forward to it at all. It's not like I do not want to get married. I really love my fiancé, and I want to spend the rest of my life with him, but for this a huge wedding with more than 100 people was not necessary. I had asked him and my parents for a micro wedding, but my parents insisted on having a huge one. They manipulated me, and I had to give in. It was a bad decision because now they are using it against me by saying that I've always been indecisive. Things have gotten worse because my fiancé has been ignoring and avoiding me for 2 weeks now for some very unknown reason. Whenever I tried to talk to him, he kept making excuses saying that he's really busy. He's been lying because he's always there when my parents need help with wedding preparations. He even took my cousins out for dinner when they were visiting us for the holidays. I was home and nobody asked me if I wanted to join. I am really heartbroken after that. I never had a good relationship with my cousins, so it was expected from their side, but from my fiancé, I never expected such a thing, and I am sure he did it on purpose. I am really disappointed, frustrated, and mad after that. I can't think of anything I have done wrong to make him this mad. I have stopped trying to contact him after that, and whenever he visits now, I make sure to leave the house before he comes. I am so tired of this now. I asked my parents to postpone the wedding, and they got really angry at me. They refused to let me postpone the wedding since all preparations are almost done. I feel misused and completely alone. Even my friends are not interested in anything I have to say. They think I am being dramatic and I need to enjoy the wedding I am getting without having to spend my own money. I act like this all isn't upsetting me anymore, but I know it is. I am hurt and confused. I feel like I have lost everybody I had. My fiancé was my best friend, only he used to provide me all the emotional support my family has always failed to provide. I do not know who I should talk to. Maybe I need a therapist, but I can't afford one right now. What should I do to make this bearable for myself? I have to go through a wedding with someone who doesn't even talk to me next month, and no matter what I do, I can't avoid it. I know asking a bunch of strangers over the internet won't really help much, but I am not left with many options now. And I will still appreciate any advice. Update. I never knew internet strangers could give me courage. I decided to text my fiancé a few hours ago and told him exactly how I am feeling because of this whole situation. Gladly, he called me immediately, which I wasn't expecting. He apologized and explained his actions. Even though I am much relieved now, I am very disappointed. My parents had asked him themselves to stop seeing me until we are married. And I clearly understand now why they did this. This is not an arranged marriage like it normally happens in our society, and my parents were very unhappy with this, but we convinced them. They told us that we all will have to make this look like an arranged marriage, and I thought it was a reasonable demand from them. When I was living on my own, I could meet my fiancé anytime I wanted, but since I moved in with my parents, they did not want us to meet without them being present. They had told me this a couple of times, and I brushed them off, so they had to talk to my fiancé without letting me know. He agreed only because he did not want my parents to kick me out since I do not have any other place to stay until I can afford one and I obviously can't move in with him yet. He also explained why he took my cousins out. My dad had asked him to spend some time with them since they won't be able to make it to the wedding next month. He knew I don't get along with my cousins and my parents also did want him to take me along. And he also acknowledged that it was still very rude of him. He told me that he visits my parents to see me, because they allowed him to meet me in their presence, and he knew I am very mad at him because I always leave the house whenever he visits. I feel so stupid to assume things. I know it's definitely my fault that I took days to completely open up about this to him. We have agreed to meet this evening. I think this has really put a dent in our relationship. No matter what, he should not have hid this from me. I need to talk to him in person before deciding if I still want to postpone this wedding. And after what my parents have done, I think they have really crossed the boundary this time. I do not think I should care about their reputation after this. I can postpone or even cancel the wedding if I feel like I should. I've honestly lost all respect for them. I again want to thank all of you for your replies. It helped more than you guys can imagine.